They can, I mean, you cannot use fasting to come out of a problem. But what you receive during fasting is what empowers you and enables you to go far above that kind of problem. But I want you to understand, there are things that can never go except by prayer and fasting. But we all know that prayer is not really what takes things out, because any prayer done without faith cannot be answered. So, and any fasting without the anointing cannot do it. So what Jesus was actually saying in Matthew 17:21, that such an issue cannot be addressed without faith and the anointing. Now let me explain a point. How does fasting bring about the anointing? Let me give you the example of Jesus. In Luke chapter 4 verse 1, the Bible talks about Jesus who was going to the place of fasting. He fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. But how was he when he went to the place of fasting? The Bible says he was full of the Spirit. He was not lacking faith. He was not lacking the Spirit. But he was lacking the anointing. If it was only faith and the Spirit that he needed to perform his duties, he could have done it without the anointing. He could have actually avoided fasting. But how does the Bible say? He went in for fasting. And they fasted 40 days and 40 nights. You see, child of God, what is it? What was the reason why Jesus had to go in for fasting? I want to explain. He was full of the Spirit. He was full of faith. He was to be converted into the anointing. That's when you read the book of Luke chapter 4 and verse 18. Actually, even verse 15. It says Jesus was full of the power of the Holy Spirit. And in verse 18, he says, the Spirit of the Lord is now upon me, for he has anointed me. Yes, he was full of the Spirit. He was full of faith, but he required to be anointed. And therefore, he had to subject the Holy Spirit. The book of Acts chapter 10 and verse 38, he says, and how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He was now anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, that he went everywhere doing good and healing all those that were sick. That tells you, child of God, that it does not just take the Spirit of God. It does not just take faith. It takes the anointing to deal with certain issues in our life. But this anointing can be acquired at the place of fasting, especially for those full of the Spirit. Because if you go to a place of fasting, when you are not filled of the Spirit, you will dry. And to avoid drying, you require to receive the Spirit. And then you go for fasting, and at the place of fasting, this amount, the same measure of the Spirit, will be converted into an equal measure of the anointing. And then this level of anointing will be able to deal with your issues as you like it. Every curse is broken because of the anointing. Every demonic altar is silenced and brought down and demolished because of the anointing. You cannot fight a spiritual war without the anointing. That I can guarantee you. Jesus knew the task ahead of him. And therefore, apart from prayer every night, apart from the Spirit of God being full in him, he had to subject himself to the place of fasting, where the measure of the Spirit in his life was turned into the anointing, and he now had the capacity to address issues. That's why he says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor and to set the oppressed free. That kind of freedom cannot come except through the anointing in one's life. Having said that, I want to address the issue of how much you can receive. You know, it is the amount of the Spirit in you that determines the amount of power you possess. You cannot contain more power than the Spirit in you. The Spirit is given without measure, but you determine how much you can contain, how much you can carry. And therefore, just like faith, you know, the Bible says in Romans chapter 12 verse 3, that faith is with measure, and everybody is to examine himself according to the quantity and the measure of faith that you have been given. Equally, the Spirit is given without measure, but you determine the measure or the amount of the Spirit you contain, and that amount of the Spirit will determine the amount of power you carry. So we do not carry the same power, because we don't carry the same Spirit, the same amount of Spirit. Even though God releases the measure, I mean the Spirit without measure, but we don't receive without measure. We receive by measure. God releases without measure, but the recipients determine the measure they are able to contain and to receive. Now, child of God, after you have received the Spirit, how do you maintain this same Spirit in your life? God gave me an illustration of a car tire, which you determine the pressure or the amount of pressure that you put in it. And he said, this car can lose touch. And therefore, God told me this, that it is easier to receive the anointing, but it's more easier to lose it. That next time you want to go on a mission, you realize you don't have any more power to use. Now, somebody can lose the anointing through a puncture. And when we talk about the puncture in the spiritual terms, we are talking about sin having the capacity and the ability to take off everything from your life. If you want to maintain the anointing in your life, then you must do away with the sinful life. You must stay away of sin. You must try your level best to do righteousness, to commit yourself and do what God wants. And number two, a car may lose pressure if it is parked next to children. The meaning of that is simple. For the anointing to be maintained, you must check your associates. You must check your friends. That's extremely important. And if you have wrong friends, they will corrupt your character. Because the Bible says, good company, bad company, corrupts good character. And the good character is the number one maintainer of the anointing and of the graces of God. And number three, we said if you park your car in a certain place for a long time, it will waste the pressure. It will reduce definitely. That's to say, if you acquire the anointing today and you don't put it into use, it might turn into a waste of time, because it will definitely reduce. And number four, which is the last one, which God recommends, is when you apply it. And therefore, if you receive the anointing and you are making good use of it, after a short period of time, it will definitely reduce. And the best you can do is go back to the same place where you received it and acquire more for the next mission. Child of God, I want to wish you all the best, that as you walk along this journey, you get to understand that every grace is supplied for a purpose and for a reason, and make good use of this grace, particularly the anointing. After you finish using it, go to the place of fasting once again. Fast according to the guiding of the Holy Spirit. Acquire as more as possible of the anointing. Come, make use of it in the miraculous. Do every kind of deliverance. Set God's people free. Let them receive their miracles. Let them receive their healing. Let them receive their breakthrough. After which, again, if it reduces at a certain level, go back for more. That means we can be fasting as many as the mission requires. God bless you. Until next time.
Ephesians 2 verse 4. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with a demonstration of the Spirit's power. Gospel Embassy Network TV, the place to feed on heavenly bread.